What's cracking, G's? That's G's and Gamer. What was you thinking? Today's video is going to be me talking about why Rockstar decided to wait so long to bring out Hikes. Okay, there's a lot of speculation, there's a lot of rumors flying around, there's a lot of thoughts. This is probably just one of them, or I could be right. You know what I mean? Like I always am. You know what I mean? But anyway, now let me stop being gassed up. Let's get to the video. Let's get to the point. Okay, first of all, guys, look, let me explain this to y'all, man, how this works. GTA, the reason the heist took so long to come out is because a lot of people started putting faith in heist after they got delayed. Now, the faith that they put in heist pretty much had the balance of GTA 5's future hanging in it. So, Rockstar knew that this was the last hurrah for GTA 5. So, what they decided to do was delay the heist because they knew they were going to come out with the next generation version of the game because the demand was there for it. I believe it sold 5 million copies, so of course the demand was there for it. At the least, last time I checked, it was at 2 million when I checked, but I heard 5 million is the number. So this is just last generation sales here, not including what they did on last gen. I'm talking about this gen. Now, with that being said, Rockstar knew that a lot of people who buy GTA would be trading their games in because they were getting mad and disappointed. A lot of game developers bring out DLC later on to actually make sure that you keep the game. A lot of game developers do not like when you trade in the game because when the game is resold to somebody who could potentially buy a new copy, they lose that sale. So this is why companies like Rockstar do not rush out DLC. In fact, they try to re-release the game with DLC on it or bring out a huge DLC so that you keep the game or more people go out and buy it. So I'm hoping that when I explain this to you guys, you understand why Rockstar did that. Now, in no way, shape, form, or fashion am I excusing what they did. You know, making us GTA crackheads wait for our fix is wrong. But at the end of the day, that was a business tactic and that was why they did that. Once heists come out, there will be updates, of course, but they know that this is the last hurrah. So they put everything they could into it, knowing that once people get heists, you know you're going to have that group of people, those hipsters that just got to call it whack, no matter whether it's hot or not. You have those people that are just going to bash it. And this could swing either way, as you've been seeing with a lot of games in today's market. A lot of games that are pretty good are getting bashed and destroyed. So, you know, Rockstar just decided to make this the last stance for the game and to milk that cow for one more gallon of milk, baby. But anyway, now let me stop being sarcastic. I actually am looking forward to the DLC. It took long to get here and it better hell be worth it. It's your boy Jimmy B Gaming. I just wanted to explain to you why this happened, because there's a lot of speculation, but at the end of the day, Rockstar is not stupid. They knew that people were gonna be waiting with pitchforks and torches for heists. They made this the last hurrah so they could get their money. They don't like when game developers lose money on reused copies being resold. So this was a way to keep the game alive a little bit longer. And also for people to see how heists work before it comes out on PC. Notice the heists are coming out before the PC version of the game. I told people that as well, because they don't believe they're going to make that much money off PC. You know why. I'm not going to get into why, because the PC guys are going to be mad. Wink, wink, wink. I patch. Wink, wink. Get what I'm saying? But anyway, yeah, I digress. I know a lot of people that are gonna buy it for PC. I spoke a couple of my friends into buying it who have PC, because they were even honestly, and I'm gonna admit it, they were talking about pirating the game, and I told them they were fucking nuts for that. How are you gonna pirate a game when the game's online is the main focus of the game? If you haven't played the story up until now, kill yourself. I'm sorry, kill yourself. You're one of those people who waited 2 years to play GTA story, kill yourself. Kill yourself. But anyway, I'm sorry. Hashtag kill yourself. But anyway, yeah. So yeah, let me know what you think in the comment section below, man. I'm gonna get out of here. I just wanted to make a commentary talking about this because you guys haven't heard from me in a little bit, and I wanted to explain that to you. Do you agree with me, disagree with me? Do you have another theory? Let me know in the comment section below. It's your boy Jimmy B Gaming. The moment I stop having fun with it, I'll be done with it. Do remember, download my Android app in the description below. T-shirts coming soon. I'm on my grind, baby. I'm out here. Later.